Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So friends, initially we have learned what is order of reaction, and based on that we have learned what is rate law. And now what we are going to do is we are going to do a derivation which is based on integrated but for the first order reaction. So let us do it. So before understanding what is integrated rate law for first order reaction, we should know what is integrated rate law. The integrated rate law is nothing but the equations which are obtained by integrating the differential rate law, and which gives a relation between concentration of reactant and time. Basically, the reaction in which the first order reaction, we are going to learn about only the first order reactions, and based on that, how can we make a relation between concentration of reactant with respect to their time? That equation is known as integrated rate law equation for first order reaction. So how to derive it? Let us see. So suppose if I consider a first order reaction, that is A is giving me product. Now you might be thinking, why I have not written B? Because it is a first order reaction, which means it will depend on the concentration of A reactant only, and will not depend on the concentration of the other reactant. So that's why I have written only, as an example, I have written the reactant A, which is giving me a product. So based on that, I know I could find out the rate of the reaction. How? I'm naming the rate of reaction as rate itself. Since A is the reactant and it is present on the left hand side, so the value of A will go on decreasing, and that the value of product will go on increasing. So the rate at which A, that is concentration of A, gets decreases, can be written as rate is equals to minus d concentration of A upon dt. That is true. And now we could also write the rate law for the above equation. The rate law for the above equation means we could write the rate law for this, that is reactant A is giving me product. So therefore, the rate law for above equation can be written as rate is equals to K concentration of A raised to X. And since this is a first order reaction, therefore X is equals to 1. Therefore the overall rate of the reaction will be rate is equals to K A raised to 1, which is nothing but concentration of A itself. So in this thing we have got two equations, that is the first one is the rate of reaction, and the next is also the rate of reaction but based on rate law. So what we are going to do is we are now going to equate this equation 1 with this equation 2. So let us see what we can do with these two equations further. So now equating equation 1 and 2, we will get minus dA, that is concentration of A divided by dt, is equals to K concentration of A. Now we have to do the integration, and now the equation that you are observing is a differentiation equation, or is a differentiation equation to which we have to integrate. So what are we going to do is now we are replacing this value of A with dt. So the equation that we get, right now is minus dA upon A is equals to K into dt. So what we are going to do, we are integrating it. So we'll now integrate this equation, because this is a differential equation. So while integrating, the value of A, that is the value of concentration, will have a lower limit also and will have a maximum limit also. So consider when the lower limit is, when A is equal to 0, means the concentration when initially been observed when time t is equal to 0. That is, at time t, when it is 0, the concentration of A will be denoted by A naught. While after a few interval of time, means when at time t is equal to t, the concentration of A would be A into t. So basically there are two factors that we are mentioning. The one in which when time t is equal to 0, then the concentration of A would be denoted as, or will have a value of A0. And after the reaction, or after the procedure of the reaction, we will observe after time t, the value of reactant is now being reduced to At. So how are we going to integrate this equation? Let us see now. So integrating the equation, we will get, I'll keep the minus aside and I'll apply the integration for when the lower limit, that is when A is A naught and when A is At. I'll integrate on the both the sides. So therefore this dt will be also be integrated when time t is equals to 0 and when time t is equals to t. Since we know the integration of dx upon x is nothing but natural log of x, similarly this equation is also related to dx, like dx upon x. So therefore the answer that we would get after equating or by integrating this equation will be natural log of A when the lower limit is A0 and the higher limit is At. And we will also similarly integrate the value of dt. So for that we should know that integration of dx is nothing but x. So replacing this dt by this dx, will get the value of, so now instead of dx we have a value of dt. So therefore by applying the integration on dt, we will get the value of t when t is equals to 0 and when t is equals to t. So this is the integral of upper limit minus the lower limit. So what we'll do is we'll equate this by when natural log of concentration of A is nothing but At minus when concentration of A is A naught. Into when t is equals to t minus when t is equals to 0. So ultimately we'll get a value of t only. So this equation can be further equated in the form of minus natural log of AT plus natural log of A0 is equals to, so we can arrange this equation as natural log of A0 minus natural log of concentration of AT is equals to K into D. Let me tell you, where A0 is nothing but the initial concentration, while the AT is nothing but the concentration that has been left after time T. So again, this equation can be arranged in the format of natural log of A0 divided by AT is equals to K into T. But this natural log can be written as, natural log can be written as 2.303 log to the base 10. So therefore, I could write this equation as 2.303 log to the base 10 A0, or I could say A0 divided by AT is equals to K into T. But we have to derive the equation for the rate law, for the first integrated rate law for the first order reaction. So therefore, I could write this equation as K is equals to 2.303 divided by T log to the base 10 A0 divided by T. So this is the final equation that we have did for the integrated rate law for the first order reaction, where K is nothing but the rate constant, T is the time required to complete the reaction from A0 to AT. So this equation can be written as K is equals to 2.303 divided by T log to the base 10 A0 divided by AT. Here K is nothing but the rate constant for the first order reaction, T is the time required to convert the initial concentration to the concentration AT. A0 is the concentration which was initially when time t is equals to 0, or the initial concentration we could say, and AT is the concentration of the reactant left after time t. So this was the equation that we have derived for rate law for the first order reaction. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to know how to derive an equation for the rate law for first order reaction, integrated rate law for first order reaction. And please don't forget to subscribe eKida channel. Thank you so much.